In this video, I'm going to show you how you can get all the benefits of an Earthship out of an average everyday house with some simple modifications for way less cost and work. Michael Reynolds, an architect, created the concept of Earthships and revolutionized home building for people who are eco-conscious and just want to live off the grid with no ties to the municipal sewer, water, or power companies. He's come up with some stunning designs for absolutely incredible homes that are completely off-grid. Now, while Earthships are a brilliant design, the reality is that an Earthship costs a lot more than a conventional house of the same size that, with some simple modifications, can basically do the same things. Earthships incorporate six main concepts: energy, garbage management, sewage treatment, shelter, clean water, and food. Earthships also have the additional goal of recycling incorporated everywhere. Let's go over these principles. First, I've explored the idea of a thermal dirt battery in a previous video. Using solar thermal collectors and a thermal battery in the ground made from clay, Earthships incorporate the thermal battery idea into the home itself on the back wall. This presents a problem with heat control, especially in climates with cold winters. On any regular home, if you have the thermal battery outside the house, you can regulate what heat you want to bring in via a thermostat and have heat distributed via radiant floors, baseboards, or a furnace with ducted vents. This means much more stable temperatures. An Earthship just uses radiant heat directly from the thermal battery, the back of the house, not allowing for much comfort control of the temperature. For air conditioning, Earthships run air tubes through their back walls to the outside to cool the air. The problem is they don't run the tubes through much material. The heatsink is small. You can run out of cooling in a hot summer. My suggestion is to dig down 6 to 8 feet and run 100 feet or more of cooling tubes, which is just ordinary weeping tile, with a simple fan circulating the air from your house through the cooling tubes in the ground and back into your house for a much larger heatsink to regulate indoor temperatures on a thermostat for much more precise temperature control. And this can be done easily on most any regular home. And finally, regarding heating, Earthships incorporate a southern-facing orientation with their windows to get solar gain. But neglect to mention, such orientation in the summer tends to cook the interior of a house, unless you have a roof overhang to take advantage of the sun's position in the summer and winter, achieving solar gain in the winter, but blocking the solar heat in the summer. Overhangs seem to be missing from many Earthship designs. Yes, vents help, but they're a pain to operate. And the more a house can be automated with the simplest technology that requires no work, the better and easier it is to live in. Self-facing windows with a roof overhang on any regular house work great for solar heat gain and don't add any additional heat in the summer. As for solar and wind electricity, the equipment used to achieve this is the same whether you have an Earthship or any regular house. There's no real advantage or disadvantage to either type of home. Garbage management is a major goal of an Earthship. Recycling is key. And the big Earthship idea is recycling tires. But tires are being recycled into other useful things now as well. Roads, shingles, artificial reefs, etc. Earthship walls aren't the only thing we can do with old tires. Personally, I think Earthship tire walls are a huge waste of time, money, and labor. When you look at the amount of labor to build an earthen tire wall, it's staggering. Unless you have free labor, and a lot of it, because making an earthen tire wall is weeks of back-breaking labor with a sledgehammer for a team of people. The idea of an economical earthen tire wall is just stupid. I believe one should just insulate your walls, well, like most houses, and keep the earthen battery outside in the ground. Recycle the dirt in your backyard into an earthen thermal battery, and you get heat on a thermostat, factoring in labor costs. An earthen thermal battery will cost you a lot less and work a lot better. As for the garbage we generate every day in our homes, how we recycle that is no different no matter what kind of home you live in, earthship or bungalow. Shelter is an easy one. An earthship or any modern home pretty much do this equally. Sewage treatment is an elaborate thing with an earthship. Some people do composting toilets, others use a bunch of expensive systems to break down the human waste into something useful for their gardens. Honestly, I don't want to use recycled human waste directly on my food. Commercial greenhouses are banned from using this material in most areas for a reason. Not only is it just gross, but there's a serious bacteria risk. Sewage is easily treated and recycled into the groundwater by a septic tank and a septic field. Rural houses have been using these systems for decades, and honestly, there isn't any reason to reinvent the wheel here. It works and it's environmentally friendly. You don't have to ration water with a well. Whatever comes out of the ground goes back into the ground, treated via your septic field. You can have high flow toilets, big bathtubs, and long showers with fresh new water and no real environmental consequence, and no recycling rainwater from your shower to your sink to your toilet and so on. Elaborate hippie septic systems designed to put your poop back into your food growing plots is just a scam that'll waste your money and possibly poison you. Earthships all praise the idea of saving rainwater, filtering it, and then after using it in one place, recycling it to the toilet to use to flush down your number one and your number two. All well and good, but every time I read about this, I cringe and ask, why don't these people just drill a well? Most locations can drill a well and get good, clean, unlimited water 50 to 400 feet down. Way less cost than installing multiple cisterns to hold rainwater. No need to recycle the well water from shower to toilet. You just use a septic field system and all the water recycles back into the ground. Imagine the cost savings of not having 5 to 6 cisterns as holding tanks for water and never having to worry about your water running out if it doesn't rain for a few months. That's how a well works. Funny, most every rural acreage operates like this and has for over a century. But earthships designed a system to use rainwater that costs 10 times as much so they can feel environmentally smug recycling rainwater that has to be highly filtered from the roof. The last topic is food. It's really cool that earthships incorporate growing food into the square footage of your home. It looks great, but reality is, when you increase the square footage of your home, most municipalities also massively increase your property taxes. The cost of the greenhouse is exponentially higher per square foot of growing space if it's part of your home versus a standalone tent-type structure beside your house. A greenhouse can be made with double wall air-inflated poly and insulation on the north wall and classified as a tent, something that isn't taxed much in any municipality. And you can have a much larger greenhouse separating it from your home for way less cost. You also avoid all the bugs and humidity associated with the growing of an abundance of plants in your house. A few houseplants is all one needs to get that oxygenized feel in the house. A full orchard growing foods is an invitation for insect infestation in your home, not something anyone ever wants. That's it. A few simple changes to most any home and you can get all the benefits of an earthship without the cost or the worry if the building inspector for your municipality will pass the plans for an earthship and even allow it to be built. Earthships are beautiful, but the reality is you can modify most any regular house to be off-grid and just as environmentally friendly as an earthship for way less cost. If you like this video and videos like this, you can actually manipulate YouTube's algorithm by subscribing and hitting the bell. By subscribing and hitting the bell, you tell YouTube these are the kind of videos you want to see more of, and YouTube will suggest more videos like this for you to watch. So hit subscribe and the bell if you want to learn more on this kind of topic. Thanks for watching. See you next time.